Hi guys. Thank you to the people who are coming back off of my previous scope. One of the growth hacks that I've learned is that if you don't have any followers, it could be because your Wi-Fi keeps crapping out on you and you need to go to 4G. As an Australian, our internet can be pretty lousy at the best of times, and I am on NBN here at home, so I should actually have a pretty decent connection, but I don't. So thank you for everyone who is piling back into the scope. I will start all over again. So thank you for people who have seen my Insta or my Twitter or my Facebook announcement to say that I'm broadcasting these growth hacks. I have been on Periscope now for 4 weeks, and these 5 growth hacks are things that I've come across. Hey Erin, nice to see you here. These growth hacks are stuff that I've come across particularly in the past 24 hours. And I know people say, oh my God, but you know, it's only 24 hours old. It's like, well, Periscope is moving so quickly. These hacks just keep popping up in our screens, especially considering they keep updating it. So here are my growth hacks. So the first thing, the one that I was saying previously, was a link in your bio. So what you can do is you can put a clickable link in your Periscope bio. This is easier to do on Android if you're an Android user, because you can actually edit the your bio description. And you need to make sure that it's a HTTP link. So you must have the HTTP in front of your link. Now, why would you do that? It's so that you can have a clickable link for people to go back to your website from their desktop. So you can then gather your subscribers to your email database, because let's face it, the money's in the email or in your list, so they say. Thanks for inviting your followers, Erin. So that's the first thing. Now, it's best to have, because your Periscope bio has, I think, 140-160 character limit, same as Twitter, it's best to use a bit.ly, hourly, pretty links, all of those link shortening facilities to actually put that link in your bio. So that's hint number one. Use a link in your bio for Periscope. The second one, is one that I have been doing, especially as an early adopter, which has helped grow my following immensely, and it's commenting. So it's getting into these kinds of broadcasts and actually commenting. Now, I don't mean the salesy follow me kind of stuff. You need to add value. You need to, hi Linda, exactly like that, exactly like what Linda's done. All right. So you need to add value, because when you do that, people see you as a person of knowledge and as a person of influence, and they will follow you. So I'm a big one on organic follow. I'm a big believer in, exactly Erin, it's this media is all about interaction, and you need to be able to interact. So I've been on some pretty big scopes, so I've been...
I don't know what you mean by SNL.
That's fantastic, Linda. I'm so glad you've been doing it. So I've been on some pretty big scopes, like Zach Spuckler. I've been on his scopes. Being social. Oh, exactly. This is what I keep saying to people. It's social media, peeps. You need to be sociable. Okay? I know some people find it hard, but that's the good thing about being on the opposite side of the camera. It's actually a little bit easier to be sociable, because people aren't seeing you. You don't have to put your face out there like I'm doing at the moment. So commenting, and people will click on, so if someone wants to put up a comment,
David,
just like
you
Erin,
are about
so
number 7.
So if we clicked on Erin's link,
what I was saying pretty much came through
her. If you like what Erin's saying, you click on Erin's little picture there, you can re-comment back to her, or if you're on Android, you at tag her, and then add Erin to your list of people to follow. So it's quite easy.
Totally. I just talk about SEO, search engine optimization.
So that's the next hack that I have, is to comment and to add value. Please don't be salesy. The next one that I've got is If This Then That. Now, this is a website that I came across. thought you'd like it. So this is a website I came across probably about 6 weeks ago.
Thanks
through
for the hearts.
A lady called Kelly O'Brien. She is a marketing person here in Australia, and she works with some of the leading coaches and gurus here in Australia doing their marketing. So Kelly O'Brien taught me,
not sure I'm perfect,
or told me about If This Then That. It's a website, and it's www.ifttt.com. So if someone would like to type that into the chat, please do. That would be helpful. So If This Then That, if you are a coder at all, runs on if-then statements. So what I do for Periscope, I have it linked to my Twitter. When I broadcast, thanks, Aaron. When I, see, being helpful. Thanks, Aaron. So when I broadcast, I link to my Twitter account.
Not live.
So people will see the link in there, and they can follow it on their website, on their laptop. I use a script in If This Then That, or they call them recipes. I use a script in If This Then That, and what it does is it takes any tweet that mentions hashtag Periscope and posts it to my Facebook wall. So that's what it does. So what I then do is that anyone who's on Facebook, who is one of my Facebook followers, and this is the main platform that I use, and it's the main platform that I coach on, they can then click on the link and follow along and play along with us too. So If This Then That, www.ifttt.com. That's it, Shannon. If This Then That, it's not it. Well, actually, it is an app. You can get the app for Android and iOS, and it's If. You need the If app for Android and iOS. Thanks, Aaron. ifttt.com.
Sure, you can post it.
So that's my third
share it all over Twitter.
So the next one I learned last night, and it's not something that, you're welcome, it's not something that was new to me, but it's a new use. So I was watching Dickie Armour, who is a UK marketing expert, has a very small following, so it's probably good to jump on and get yourself known with Dickie. I found Dickie through Laura Husson. And I found Laura Husson through the Sarah Moore, who is an Australian. So, just giving kudos to the people that I found.
IFTTT is maybe too automated.
So, Dickie Armour was talking about this thing called Perimail, like Periscope Mail. I was like, what? Like, who? I didn't know that Periscope has this app that allows me to send webmail or inboxes directly to people. I was like, what? This must be an iOS hack. It's not. So what Dickie Armour was saying was that you can send a private scope. It's like, yeah, well, that's nothing new. My first two scopes were private scopes. So what you do is, and what he's suggesting, is like the thing that's coming around about doing Twitter video to thank Twitter followers. So what you can do is when you find somebody who you really want to engage with and really connect with, remember, this is social media. It's all about connections, like, know, and trust. Remember, like, know, and trust. So you need to then click on a private scope, set up a private scope with one of your with the follower, and just scope with them. Now they'll receive a notification to say that they've received a scope from you. Open it up, and you know, you can say whatever you like. See, facts. So what it does is it opens up these channels of communication. It shows that you're a real person. I mean, not the Periscope doesn't, because we're all getting on their live. We're not bots or anything like that. You're a real person. You provide engaging content. You care about them. Because let's face it, the way that followings are growing, I'm not going to be able to respond to each and every person. It's not going to happen. I know, it is pretty sweet. It's one of these personalized things that... really shows the heart of your business. So that's my fourth one, is Perimail. So thanks to Dickie Armour for pointing that one out to me. So the last one that I have, so there was five. The last one that I have is Great If You Have, a web page where you are broadcasting all of your, or sharing all of
Correct.
your,
totally agree.
your periscope streams.
I think
so
the other parts
I just
of the
set up a
internet
page
are even
last
worse.
night on the right to right page, and I have, you can watch the replay, Aaron, and then you can write them all down. So, or follow along and I'll get there. So in 24 hours time, I will be uploading this scope to my YouTube channel and also to my website. So that would be righttoright.com.au/periscope. So on that periscope page, I have a button which says follow me on periscope. Yeah, you can do it. So
it's
people are saying, but
comments,
I can't
yeah.
get people to follow me. So this
you
is one that I learnt the day before yesterday from a guy called Kerry Shearer, K-E-R-R-Y-S-H-E-A-R-E-R, Kerry Shearer. He is a broadcaster from the US, and I really like Kerry because it's down-to-earth, facts, helpful hints, those kinds of things. He did a great scope yesterday about getting the sound right for when you're scoping a Skype call. That's a big thing at the moment, is Skyping interviews. So the big thing that Kerry shared, now Kerry was doing an interview with the lady called Christy Clover, who runs a mummy blog called Raising Clovers. And she has added to her blog a periscope follow button. So you do this by going to, and you're going to want to pin, and I'm going to go slowly. So you need to go to a website called Watch on Periscope. So it's watchonperiscope.com, watch as in, one of these scope things, on, periscope.com. So you go to watchonperiscope.com, you click search, you type in your handle that you use for Periscope. So this works for broadcasters. Thanks, Sarah. You type in your handle, you click on the box that comes up and it says follow on Periscope. There's a green button or a red button. I did it late last night, so I can't remember. So you click on the button there that says watch on Periscope and it will add you to the following. So I'll follow on Periscope. So you click on the follow button and what it'll do is up the top it'll bring up the URL. Have the URL in the search in the address bar for your website on the Watch On website. Copy that URL and embed it as a link in the button on your website. So if you are building websites yourself, if you are building and maintaining your own website, this is something you can do. Otherwise, you can
so obvious.
Click
I didn't
as
think of that.
A normal
HTTP
link in your blog. So you can just highlight, click link and then paste that in there so you can just have the text that says follow me on Periscope.
Oh, that's so obvious.
Click Bing. It takes the
and
person
I've been using
through to
site
watch on
telling
Periscope.
Everyone about it for 4 weeks.
Click on the button that says
I'm like,
follow
where the heck is a URL on this tab?
You appear in their list. They get your notifications that you are live and this is a way that you can get people to follow you on Periscope from the desktop. So it's a hack to allow you to get to more people to grow your following. So that's my five. So I'm just going to go back to my list. So the five that I've shared with you today is a HTTP link in your bio.
I can't believe I didn't think of that.
If this, then that, for sharing out to your Twitter and or from your Twitter to your Facebook. Perimail. Thanks, Sarah. Email, so using private broadcasts to thank your fans for following you. Comments, so being helpful in comments like Sarah and Linda and Aaron are doing, being helpful in your comments, that will help you grow your Periscope following. And the final one is watchonscopes.com and adding it to your website as a link so that you can gain followers online. So they're my five. My big, 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 big. So I'm going to give you a sneaky one. Six one is be open, be genuine, be honest. Because like I said before, this is all about connections and developing a relationship with your followers. So everyone says it's about like, know, and trust. And it seriously is. It's social media. You need to develop this relationship with your followers. So be open, be honest, and you will grow your business. And then the next thing that I was going to say is, I'm all for the big stuff. So I will not ask people to heart my stuff. I will not ask you for hearts, and I will not ask you to share my broadcast. The reason why is because I want people who actually want to be here. So if you're showing me hearts, or if you're inviting your followers to these scopes, you are showing me that you enjoy my content and you feel that it is actually valuable. So that's it. So if you want to see what I'm doing with Periscope on my website, it is www.writetowrite.com.au/periscope, or there is a bit.ly link in my bio. So you can go to watchonscope.com and click through there. You'll see the link in the bio, or you can click through on the desktop and you can see exactly how I'm using Watch on Scope. Thank you, Sarah. You can see directly what I'm doing there. So yeah, thanks guys. I'm going to sign off now and I'm going to enjoy the rest of this school holiday day with my children. All right, see you later.